Let's talk about Havix. It's a twin-stick Dynasty Warriors game, as I'd like to describe it. When you start it off, you pick 5 super soldiers that you get to, of course, customize appearance-wise and what loadouts they have in terms of their melee capabilities and their range capabilities. But you also get to pick some options for them, options being 2 smaller units that follow them around, like in Gradius or Kingdom Hearts 2, or more like Ratchet Deadlocked, if anything, really. And those can provide more range support, or can heal, or maybe like a shield person. You know, something that either to help you specialize your character, or to make up for their weaknesses. And you'll really want to make sure that they're good, because it's going to be permadeath for each character. Now, when you start a campaign, you have a hexagonal grid, maybe octagonal, and your objective is like in Dynasty Warriors, take over all the territory, and you'll like move your units into each space, and each space will probably have a battle in it. And those battles are large scale encounters between just tons and tons of dudes. Of course, your super soldier can just run about and destroy everything. Probably from a top down isometric perspective, kind of like those PS1 games where characters are sprites and the world is kind of 3D. At least that's how it always appeared in my head. I don't exactly know why. Something like Xenogears, it would look kind of like Xenogears, especially with the abilities. There'd be different camera angles depending on what's going on. Like, it will probably zoom in when your character's doing an execution, or like pull out when new enemies come in. It would be very much. And since it's twin stick, you'd have multi-directional shooting, multi-directional slashing. Because there's just going to be hordes and hordes of dudes coming at you, and you've got to just chop through all of them. And when your characters die, they're, as I said before, they're gone. And now you have to try to finish the whole conflict on this map of hexagons using only 4 of your dudes. Or 1, if that's the last one you have. And if you lose them all, well, then I guess you have to use the mooks to win.
Never trust the mooks.